former Egyptian army chief Abdel Fattah el-Sisi won a sweeping victory in his presidential bid against Hamdi Sabahi in May, but the vote is raising questions.
Egypt's election commission says Mr. Sisi took nearly 97% of the vote, with voter turnout at just 47%. So what does this say about Egypt's political climate? On Assignment's Doug Bernard spoke with VOA's Elizabeth Arrott in Cairo.
There's been no element of surprise in terms of the result. Everyone saw this coming for almost a year now since the overthrow of Morsi. So we haven't seen very big demonstrations either in favor of him or opposed to him. I mean, part of the problem, too, is because this is very much, in the opponent's point of view, a return to the past, there really aren't that many avenues now for protest. So it's been very calm.
How do people feel? I mean, are they happy? Are they blasé? Are they cynical? What's the mood?
It's very mixed, as Egypt has been very divided over the last year and before that even. But what you're seeing, you know, from the opponents is a sense of resignation that's gone back to Egypt's sort of longstanding tradition of a man from the military in a sort of an oppressive, heavy-handed state. For other people, for his supporters, who apparently there are less of them than people had thought, they're quite happy in that they think that maybe he'll be able to sort of rein in some of the chaos that we've seen since the revolution.
Even his supporters acknowledge popular resentment.
I thought, I love this man. Why not get a picture of him? So I got it, but every time I go up in a building, I come back to find the picture shredded.
Syed, who prepares and delivers the popular dish koshri on the streets of Cairo, remains a fan of the man he credits with keeping the revolution of 2011 on track. This despite Sisi's similarities to fellow military leader Hosni Mubarak, the target of that uprising.
Elizabeth, what are the challenges of being a journalist covering an election where you know the results before the ballots have even been printed?
Well, it does make it easier to sort of anticipate what your lead's going to be. But actually, this wasn't without surprises. The biggest thing was, even though everybody knew that Sisi would win, would be how many people would come out to vote. And I think that's where the journalists and also citizen journalists were very important in this. They extended voting by an extra day, they declared a holiday, they threatened non-voters with fines, and then they came up with, there was a number of 47% of voter turnout. It does not jibe, that official number, with the reports we're getting from the field. I saw empty polling stations on the second and third day, and it seems very hard to see how that number jumped. And so sort of my observations, the observations of journalists all over the country, and again, you know, just citizens taking, you know, tweeting pictures of polling stations, that was an important element, I think, in seeing that Sisi doesn't necessarily have the kind of, you know, the broad-based support that people had thought he had. So that was an interesting angle to covering this election.
It's often said that strong rulers want large electoral victories as a measure of their legitimacy. How in any way was this even an election, and how could anyone consider it legitimate?
Well, it certainly followed certain forms of an election. There don't seem to be, in terms of the numbers, probably of the people who voted legitimately, it probably was 90-some, you know, 90-plus. You know, it's the kind of numbers you saw across the Arab world before the Arab Spring. So in that sense, it's not. But it's also back to this level of political repression, and which makes, you know, people raise the question of legitimacy, of lack of any kind of political arena for opposition.
Finally, any sense as to when some of that fear may subside and people may be a little bit more emboldened to even criticize al-Sisi?
Well, oddly enough, it may not be the political sphere, but the economic one that may bring people back out on the streets in bigger numbers. They're looking in the next couple of months at a very, very hot summer, as usual, but very little, you know, there's great power shortages. And that kind of economic hardship combined with higher prices, cuts in subsidies, that's the kind of thing that I think Sisi may be up against, or any president would have been up against in the coming months. That could be, you know, a way of getting at sort of opening the political sphere once again, but because of economic reasons.
VOA Cairo correspondent Elizabeth Arrott. Mr. Sisi has been seen as a driving force behind a crackdown on dissent in Egypt. Just days after his inauguration, an Egyptian court sentenced 25 pro-democracy activists to 15 years in prison.